Yo, it's your boy Tag. You know who it is, the average gamer, coming to you direct with another commentary. Y'all know I don't do commentary very often. I throw instrumentals in the background, put some gameplay out. So when I do get on the mic, show me some love and listen. You don't have to thumbs it up. You don't have to do anything. Just enjoy. You know what I mean? All right. I'm going to talk to you guys about the Modern Warfare 3 experience. What I saw this weekend on the live stream was incredible. I mean, I saw a lot of gameplay. I heard a lot of different commentaries talking about what the game is going to be like, what the perk systems are, and I mean, just everything. So if you look off to your right, just scroll your eyes over there to the right. You'll see over in my favorites, because I've set my channel up so you can view my favorites instead of just viewing my videos. You view my favorites because in my favorites, I've saved you a lot of time and a lot of effort. You don't have to run all over the internet trying to find official gameplay with clarity and things like that, and official comments from commentators, YouTube commentators and gamers out there with the experience of having been in LA to see what's actually going on. So look over to the right in my favorites. You'll see all of Modern Warfare 3 things that I could gather in a short period of time for you to view at any given time. Okay, so if you're very busy and didn't have time to view the live stream or view any of the videos and you just don't have a lot of time in your day, I've set you up. So don't thank me. I'm just an enthusiast. I like first-person shooters just like everybody else, and you know, it's just fun for me to do things like that. Anyway, let's talk about some things that are not in Modern Warfare 3. There will be no second chance. There will be no nukes. There will be quick scoping. There will be that fun factor that we've been missing. Black Ops is cool. Black Ops has theater mode. Black Ops has a lot of different things that are user-friendly. But guess what, Black Ops? You're slow-paced. Your hit detection is off. And sometimes the characters look a little bit cartoony. I mean, they look like when they're running, you know, when you have your pistol in your hand and you're running, it looks like you just jumped off a horse and your legs hadn't collapsed so they can close back together correctly. You know what I mean? It's just crazy. But anyway, I'm not going to bash Black Ops because I played it, I bought the downloadable content, and I continue to play it. It frustrates me because sometimes based off internet connection or things of that nature, and just some things that go on within the game, it's frustrating. But I'm still able to play it, it's still playable, and for a lot of people, it's very enjoyable. Modern Warfare 2, to me, had more fun factor. I like fun factor. I mean, when I picked up that game, all I could do was just play. And that's the first first-person shooter. No, actually the second. The first one I got was Killzone 3. My cousins and friends were saying, no, get up off that game. That's not the game for you. Now, I like Killzone 2. I mean, I think it was Killzone 2 next. And then I purchased Killzone 3. Anyway, I still like that game. I still think it's a great game. It doesn't get its just due. But Modern Warfare 2, wow. I still play it today. My son and I, we still play the game together. We get on there, man, and we have fun. It's the fun factor that brings me back to this genre of Modern Warfare 2, now to 3, in the Call of Duty series for many of you. I've played the Battlefield games. I've played the Medal of Honor. Those games are great, too. They have great cosmetics, but it's so expansive that you can't do any of the... If you like arcade style of play, you're not going to really appreciate all the wonderful things that they've done in Battlefield. But if you like arcade play, over the top things, crazy things like that, then you will. Oh, one more thing I've got to say. There will not be any more Commando in Modern Warfare 3. Okay? No more one-man army. Okay? I didn't mention that. So. And quickscoping is back. Yes, quickscoping is back. Let me say it one more time. For all you quickscoping, is back. Okay, don't stop doing the game. So anyway, let's talk about the Call of Duty edit. They actually, what they've done is probably taken something from some other games that I heard about. Someone was mentioning that Halo 3 had some things like this. Crysis 2 had things with the dog tags. If you kill somebody, You have to actually capture their dog tag in order for it to be a confirmed kill. Like I said, all these things will be in the video off to the right. So just bear with me right quick, as I mean, there's just so much going on. Now the Call of Duty Elite, you can get it for free. You can go online, register, get it for free, and you'll be able to experience some things like your statistics and things like that, your friend's statistics, and see if they're online. But if you, here's the catch, if you pay $49.99 for the year, you get the premium subscription. And that means you can do the game battles, you can upload your videos from their site, which would be great for commentators or great for people like me who just like to throw videos up there just to have fun, or just to show my friends, hey, check this out. Look, I'm not as much as a noob as you thought I was. Okay? So $49.99 plus the $60 for the game. That's $109. Okay? Also, what that $49.99 includes is all the DLC packages. Now, they said there were going to be about four. So if you calculate 15 times 4, that's $60. If you purchase things separate, the downloadable content separate, and then you purchase the game, you know, that's $120 out of pocket. It's over a period of time, not all at once. But if you do it all at once, it's $49.99 plus the $60, plus $99. I'm no mathematician, but that's great math. I'm not putting any taxes because I don't know what region you live in, so your taxes could be a little bit different than mine. Now, what trumps all of that is if you buy the Hardened Edition of Modern Warfare 3 for $99.99, you get everything. You get all the downloadable content. You get the Call of Duty Elite subscription for the year. You get everything. So my higher math tells me, go buy the Hardened Edition. This is a ploy, of course, to get you to buy more units at a higher price, and also to compete with the Battlefield 3 experience, which is about to drop, which looks great, looks amazing. So there's going to be a big revenue competition. Okay, fanboys, step back. We're not talking about you. If you like a certain genre of game, you like Battlefield 3, you like Modern Warfare 3, go into your neutral corners and like your game, and stop getting everybody else to like your game because you think your game is better. None of you are getting paid for it, so chill out. Okay. So also, if you purchase the Call of Duty Elite premium subscription, then you will receive downloadable content once a month. You don't have to wait to almost every quarter, to almost a year. You know, every quarter you get the new downloadable content. Every month you will receive new downloadable content every month. Okay.